Okay, thank you for writing this book. You've written a lot of books. Thank 11 you. Or 12 books, I think.
Uh-huh.
You've been a huge voice in the last few years, and you just came into the Senate in 2011. I think a lot of people probably don't know that.
Actually, 2013.
Oh, shoot's
put me.
Sorry,
yeah, exactly.
2013. You came into the Senate in 2013, and so you've made a lot of noise, and you've had a huge impact on the middle class, on Wall Street. Talk to me a little bit about growing up and why the middle class is so important to you and why minimum wage is such an issue for you.
So I grew up in a family that was really just kind of hanging on to our place in the middle class by our fingernails. So we had, like a lot of families, ups and downs. And when I was about 12, my daddy had a heart attack, long period with no money coming in, and we were a paycheck to paycheck family. And my mother, who was 50 years old, had never worked outside the home. And I still remember the day that she cried, she put on her best dress, and pulled on her high heels and walked to the Sears to get a minimum wage job. And that minimum wage job saved our home and it saved our family. And we got our chance because I grew up in an America where a minimum wage job would support a family of three and you could make a mortgage payment. The America of today, a minimum wage job will not support a mama and a baby and keep them out of poverty. And that's the big difference, is that government once worked for working people and now, man, it's out there to work for the thin slice at the top.
Can you expand on that part of the book? You talk about a lot of personal stories of different individuals throughout the country in this book, which resonated with me. And you talk a lot about what Walmart does, which is, they pay people minimum wage, and then they're subsidized by our tax money to pay those people paltry salaries.
Walmart pays its employees so little that the employees then just bear sustenance. They then turn to the taxpayers to get food stamps, to get rent subsidies, to get subsidized health care. So the taxpayers are actually subsidizing Walmart so that the Walmart shareholders can get a bigger rate of return. You know, if Walmart just paid a higher salary and the shareholders got a little bit less, then the taxpayers would be off the hook.
Another big infamous moment of yours was recently when Mitch McConnell basically told you to shut up on the Senate floor and to stop talking. How's that relationship going now?
He finally said hello to me.
Did he apologize?
Oh, please, nothing like that. But you know,
what did you say when he said hello to you?
Oh no, I said hello to him first and he finally said hello back. The first few times I said hello, he didn't even say hello back. You know, the way I see this about that one, this really isn't about me. I felt like this was about every woman in America who has been told loud and clear, sit down and shut up. And women who've just said, I've had it. I'm not doing this anymore.
It feels like things are going to go backwards unless women stand up and scream and fight, and so do men, and for men have to stand up for us too. I know people talk about you running all the time in 2020. Do you feel motivated to consider that or contemplate that because of the situation we find ourselves in today?
So, look, I'm not running for president. I am running for the Senate in 2018. I'm in that fight all the way.
Well, I'll be there.
Oh, good. Thank you. We have got to be focused on what Donald Trump and the Republicans in the House and the Senate are doing to our country right now. This is a moment when we have got to put country ahead of party. And country ahead of party here means some accountability and constraints on Donald Trump. And instead, right now, Republicans in the House and the Senate, they're running in the opposite direction.
But equally important, the idea that somebody like Paul Ryan or Mitch McConnell would be all right with having us in the hands of the Russians while they're laughing at us because he's telling them classified information is really scary.
Yes, it is.
So what, your message to people and everyone in this country about what they can do, and obviously everyone needs to continue to call their congresspeople, call their representatives.
Yeah.
But is there anything else that you would say to that?
So the first thing I think everyone ought to do is join a group. And if you already belong to one, belong to two, belong to three, belong to four, and there's a reason for that. It's partly because one voice is loud, but two voices is more than twice as loud. And groups help each other stay focused. They talk about, this is the fight that's in front of us right now, because there are so many fights around us. And a second one is recruit. Don't just talk to the people who already agree with you. Don't just talk to the people who are already engaged and ready to go. You've got to talk to people who are who are more on the edge, who may not be following as much, you got to talk to your crazy uncle. You got to talk to the people behind you in line at the grocery store and the people pumping gas next to you. You got to do that because we've got to keep expanding the number of people who are engaged in these issues.
Yeah.
And the third thing, commit. You got to make a commitment yourself, whatever it is. You're going to make a phone call every day. You're going to send an email. You're going to have one new conversation. You're going to meet one new person and talk about this issue. We're now at a moment in America where democracy is on the ropes. Donald Trump and Paul Ryan and Mitch McConnell have put this country in a place it has never been before. Everything from the Russians laughing at us to what happens to healthcare for millions of Americans. This is our moment in history, and we gotta fight back.
I just wanna say, I want to remind you of this picture, because if you could look back at yourself and give yourself a preview of what would have happened and what your life would have turned into, you probably wouldn't have believed it.
No, not even close.
I mean, look how innocent this girl is.
I know.
She may still be, I don't know, but she's a good fighter.
That was a little girl with a dream, though. She wanted to be a public school teacher, and it all took college, and I'm so deeply grateful to an America that invested in college and invested in our kids, so I got that chance.
Yeah, well, I love the book. Thank you so much for sitting down with me. It was great to meet
you.
Thank you, guys. Since you got to the end of that video, I'm going to show you something that's going to blow your mind. I realize that I've never walked up this staircase on my set, and I don't know what's behind this door at the top, so we're just going to find out together. And
hey guys, hit the subscribe button right now for more videos.